All right. Okay, let me see here. They come to their senses and escape from the death.
Happened to real music,
man. I'm talking the good old days. Yeah. AC/DC, Highway to Hell. I'm on
one,
a highway to hell.
Hey, don't stop me.
That's what I'm talking about.
Missing those great heavy metal songs that set the world's feet a-stomping? Cool Out Concession Records has just put together 30 of the top metal hits of the me generation into one double record set. Notes from the Underground. Bang Your Head to the sizzling sounds of Alice Cooper. Go to Hell. Kiss Hotter Than Hell. Cramped Aloha from Hell. Grim Reaper. See You in Hell. CGSS Citizen of Hell. Rigor Mortis. Condemned to Hell. AC/DC. Highway to Hell. Twisted Sister. Burn in Hell. Cheap Trick. Gonna Raise Hell. Merciful Fate. Princess of Hell. Raven. Hell Patrol.
And big sister to megastar Michael Jackson, is this month's cover girl for Playboy. In a recent interview with USA Today, she relates how when she was first approached by the soft porn magazine, she said, "Absolutely not, I am not that kind of..."
Here we have what appears to be some sort of hideous, bizarre Egyptian curse of the lyrics to the latest Iron Maiden hit.
Oh, come on, I don't believe this.
One can never be too sure.
What is wrong with this man? Is this just a good time, or is there something of a deeper significance going on here as well? What type of effects does this music have upon people? Is it only rock and roll? Questions and others will be answered as Hell's Bells takes you on a journey to the heart of rock and roll. You'll discover what it can do to an egg, your head, your life, and your eternal soul. We'll explore rock's relationship to sex, violence, suicide, drugs, rebellion, and most importantly, the occult. Come with us now as we join our host, Eric Holmberg, founder and director of Real to Real Ministries, for Hell's Bells, The Dangers of Rock and Roll.
Thanks for taking the time to watch this video. And I hope and pray that you'll get something good, maybe even life-changing out of it. Before we get started, however, I wanted to make a few points clear, kind of lay down the ground rules for you. First, we're going to be taking a pretty hard look at contemporary music, and I'll be saying some pretty direct things, both about the music and the artists. Please understand that nothing personal is intended here against anybody. I don't hate these artists. I'm not trying to say that God hates them, and I'm certainly not trying to get you to hate them. We simply want to look at rock music from the perspective of truth as defined by both the scriptures and the person of Jesus Christ. And in that context, if we find something that looks like a duck, sounds like a duck, and acts like a duck, then shoot, we're just going to have to call it a duck. Now, you might not believe that the Bible and Jesus are the standard for absolute truth, and that therefore, their comments as they relate to rock music are irrelevant. Well, don't get uptight. We'll hopefully deal with the issue of faith as we progress, but at least at the outset, try to keep an open mind and at minimum understand that, right or wrong, what you're about to see and hear is what the Bible and Jesus have to say about these things. Now, you might also find some of the information about the artists and the music incredible, maybe even hard to believe. Please understand that every point has been carefully researched and documented. All quotes, for example, were taken either from the artist's own writings, rock magazines, books on musicology, or biographies written by sympathetic fans. Because of the wealth of material we're going to cover, and in the interest of time and the aesthetics of this presentation, I'm not going to generally cite the sources. If you're interested, the closing credits will contain information on how you can get a copy of the script along with all the documentation. And finally, to preempt the inevitable outcries of censorship, let me go on record. We're not here pushing for record banning, record burning, or even the dubious practice of rating rock albums. So don't anybody worry. We're not trying to control what people listen to. What we are trying to do is help people understand the big picture, to peel back the veneer of pop culture and gaze into the bedrock of truth that lies beneath. Then people can make decisions about their lives, music, or anything else, armed with truth and understanding. Now, as we begin our video journey to the heart of rock and roll, let's listen to probably the only true thing that Wendy O. Williams and the Plasmatics ever laid down on vinyl. Appropriately enough, it was recorded backwards.
So near by the one and so near by the house, there's needs in the Americorpsis.
When we play the tape reversed, we hear
consensus programming is dangerous to your health. The brainwashed do not know they are brainwashed.
The brainwashed do not know they're brainwashed.
At 12:32 a.m. Wednesday morning, a performance by the popular punk rock group The Huns was cut short when police arrested the group's volatile lead singer Phil Tolstead. Charged with inciting a riot, this incident becomes the latest in a young and sordid career that has featured not only the standard spewing forth of obscenities and hate, but has also included mock crucifixions and the ridicule of God in prayer. The confrontation is said to have begun as Tolstead pointed at a uniformed police officer while singing the Huns' song, Eat Death, Scum.
Rock and roll is a lie, and that lie almost killed me.
That's right, Mike. Rock and roll. Powered by space-age technology and popularized by the largest, wealthiest, and most leisure generation of young people in history, rock music has changed the modern world in ways more profound than perhaps any other social phenomenon. Evidence of its impact are many and varied. Rock has become a multi-billion dollar industry, one recently described by the National Review as the most prosperous industry in the world. Its superstars have annual incomes that easily eclipse those of all but a handful of the most successful industrialists and businessmen. And the music is virtually everywhere, from packed sports arenas to commercials that peddle everything from tennis shoes to alcohol.